Sometimes the slug would go away, sometimes it wouldn't go away. Sometimes that sluggy looks right into your eyes. You know the thing about a slug, he's got lifeless eyes, black eyes like a doll's eyes. The way he comes at the cabbage doesn't seem to be living till he bites the leaves and those black eyes roll over white. Then you hear the terrible high-pitched screaming.
Ah! My cabbages! Hey, welcome to Choo. My name is Jacob, and in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to get rid of an absolute metric shit ton of slugs using a cheap and effective method and not using any store-bought baits. I'm not opposed to baits per se, but I think we can all agree that the less shit we put into the ground, the better, right? So I still use baits every now and then, but in this video, I'm going to show you an alternative. So essentially what we're going to be making is a beer trap, right? All you need is some kind of container, like a takeaway plastic. If you don't have that much plastic in your house, you can just use like a bowl. Doesn't really matter. Just pop that in the ground. Make sure the dirt is flush with it. Fill it up with beer. Cover it up with something like this. Wait. It's literally that simple. Now, if you're not getting much action in there, it's probably because it's not yeasty enough. So you can always add yeast to it. So the slugs and other little critters are going to be attracted to sort of high yeasty things. So if your beer isn't yeasty enough, or it's not a wheat beer or something like that, you want like creamy thickness, dark ale works really well. You can always add packet yeast. This is going to increase your cost, obviously. So typically you want to avoid that. An alternative is you could add something that is yeast based, like Vegemite in there, and create like a little goo. Cover it up and off you go.
So we recently had a Choo shindig and some bogan left this here. I'm looking at you, Alex. So like I said, if it's not yeasty enough, sometimes these non-crafty beers, they're cheaper, but they're not as effective. So mix in a little bit of store-bought yeast or bread yeast, it's quite cheap, and some Vegemite, make like a beer and Vegemite slurry. All you gotta do, one for you, one for me. God, that's a bad beer. One for you. And just continue like this until it's full and you're pissed. I can't drink this beer. It's fucking shit. Fucking who drinks that? God damn it. Right. Then just make sure the dirt is level so the slugs and other little slaters and shit can actually get in there. Okay, so you bring all that dirt up. And of course you can put a little bit of wood over here. You could put some tin over there. I'm just gonna use a shovel for now to keep the rain out so it doesn't dilute it. Come back in a few days and you should have a whole thing full of slugs for super cheap. There's a very, very simple and effective method. So we're gonna come back in a few days and see what is in there.
Alrighty then, okay. So day one, we had a really big leopard slug, which was pretty interesting. They're really gross. One of the biggest species of slugs though, kind of cool. Absolutely mashes your garden. So we don't want that in here. I just leave them here to go back into from whence they came. Let's have a look what we got on day two. Oh, so this is one thing you'll see. We'll do a close up in a minute. You can actually see all the yeast has started to grow, which is not great. That's what happens when you put packet yeast in there. But as you can clearly see, there are plenty of slugs in here. I still have snail bait all around because it's not enough. You have to build hundreds of these. You're going to be replacing it with beer every 3 or 4 days. So if you're doing that once a week, let's say, that's a lot of beer that you could be drinking. However, if you get on top of them straight away, you're not going to have that massive buildup of slugs, right? So this is totally effective, as you can clearly see. So give it a go at home.
Oh, it actually smells really good. Ugh, that one's definitely gone. Right. Anyway, it's probably more in there. You get the point.
The thing about baits you have to be careful of is there's two types of snail baits. One which is super toxic. It's got methylodilate or whatever. I'll put it here. I don't know sciences. The other one just uses like an iron composite thing, motherfucker. I'll put that here. The iron one is pet friendly, but it's not that great for other bugs. It'll kill slugs and snails, but it won't really kill like all the little other shit like slaters or pill bugs, which are okay in small quantities, but in, as they build up, they become really nasty. So snail bait's fine. I use it sparingly, but every now and then. This is super effective, and that's not hurting anyone. You can just tip the beer straight into your garden. It's not hurting anyone. Just make sure you cover it. You could also get a plastic container with a lid, have some slits in there. As long as that dirt comes up, you're good to go. Trust me, this is a really, really self-sufficient way, especially if you make your own beer, which I haven't. Have in the past. Super self-sufficient way, cheap and affordable to massively reduce your slug infestation. Yo.
Could have a winter party and then all those dead soldiers in the morning. Use that beer.
The dead soldiers. Yeah. Okay, good one, Quinn. So what my wife was saying there is, often, actually we had one, right? We had a stout. Someone left an entire long neck of stout out. So yeah, have a party in the middle of winter. You're probably going to find a whole ton of half beers that some dickhead hasn't drunk. Free beer in your beer trap. You were going to tip that down the sink anyway, or maybe if you're like me, you might finish them off the next morning. Anyway, I've been Jacob. You've been watching Choo Brew. If you like this sort of short form videos, I think this one's going to be pretty short, let me know, and I can bang out a whole bunch of other sort of pest controls that are more organic. It'll save you a few bucks, so you're not just buying and spraying and buying. Like I said, I do buy pellets, I do buy pesticides, I do buy herbicides, because I use them. I'm not completely organic. I don't necessarily subscribe to that. It's more about reducing your dependency on these things as it is, as opposed to completely eliminating them. At least that's my theory. Sometimes you're busy and it's just easier to throw some snail bait down. I get it. I'm not opposed to that. But if you want to try something else, perhaps give the beer trap a go. Cheers.
Cheers, Ev. Gizev, quick!
Compliment me.